Belinda and ABC Audio present this unabridged recording of Truly Tan Shocked, written by Jen Storer and read by Roslyn Oades. The dedication reads, "For all Tan fans old and new, this book is for you, JS. For dear Phil, CR." Episode 1, Goblins, Boyfriends, and a Magic Yurt. School is over for another week, and I am thankful to be here in my world-class treehouse and secret spy world headquarters. Birds are twittering at the window, and they are happy there is no one here to bark at them. Awesome is back at the house. He is trying to get my big sister, Emerald, to give him a barbecue shape. I told him, "Awesome, you are asking for heartbreak." Of course, Awesome is a very determined dog. But Emerald is a very determined sister. She does not get involved with pets of any description, even the exceptional ones. It is my belief that Emerald will win this latest barbecue shape battle. I flop down at my desk. I am in a floppish mood. I pick up my magic eight ball and give it a shake. "Oh, wise and famous magic eight ball, knower of all things hidden and important and interesting, please answer my question. Are you listening?" "You may rely on it." "Magic eight ball, tell me this. Is everything going to change for the worse soon?" "Concentrate and ask again."
Is my life going to get boring, and am I going to be of no interest to anyone in this family ever again?"
"Ask again later."
"But it is later,"
I yell.
"Magic eight ball, stop mucking around and answer me. Is my life about to get ruined?"
"Cannot predict now."
I throw the magic eight ball at the beanbag. My three-legged cat, E, howls and leaps out of the beanbag. "E, I'm so sorry. I didn't know you were there. Thank goodness you didn't get hit. A flying magic eight ball could dislocate your head."
E hisses at me, jumps up onto the windowsill, and sends a line of secret spy storage tins flying across the floor. There is stuff everywhere. Rats, bats, I feel like I'm living in a curse today. I am down on my knees, picking up thumbtacks and pencils and paper clips and my collection of cicada shells that have not yet been categorized when, bring! The secret spy cordless phone starts ringing. This better be for me and not for one of my sisters. I am not a secretary for Emerald, Amber, and Rose. I am not a secretary for the lollipops. I am a secret spy. I am running an international spy ring from this treehouse, and I am a busy person. Bring! "Hello," I say in my official voice. "Identify yourself."
"Breaker, breaker, the flying pigs have overshot the runway."
"The tram has eaten the tram tracks," I say. "Do you copy?"
"The lime spider walked the tightrope."
"The lime spider rode a coconut."
"It is you. Hello, Tad. It's Gloria."
Gloria is on the phone. Gloria is my best friend and secret spy partner. And unlike me, who lives way out in the middle of nowhere, Gloria lives smack bang in the centre of town, which is handy. Gloria always has her finger on the pulse. She has Peppercorn Valley under constant surveillance, and it doesn't even know. That's how good she is at her job.
"I'm pleased to hear from you, my old friend," I say. I've been talking to the magic eight ball. I asked it about the you-know-what. End? Connection failed. Try again later.
Huh! Did it really say that?
More or less.
Ted, the magic eight ball is toying with you. Every time you've made inquiries about this burning issue, it has failed you. I don't think it has a clue how to help. Or maybe...
Maybe what?
Maybe you're asking the wrong questions.
Not possible, Gloria. The Magic 8-Ball and I have a long and trustworthy relationship. I know Magic 8-Ball speak, and it knows Tan Callahan speak. We are in sync.
Be that as it may, I think you need to stop nagging the Magic 8-Ball about your problems and start focusing on all the positive things in your life.
Such as?
You're turning 10 soon, Tan!
Yes!
You're catching up to me.
Yes!
We're going to be the same age.
Yes!
Plus, says Gloria, I have some compelling secret spy news that is bound to cheer you up.
Really? Tell me now!
Well, says Gloria, you know how our teacher, Miss Dragone, has been acting weird and out of character and peculiar?
Affirmative. Turning up late for class, letting us out early for recess, being kind and considerate to a variety of students other than her official favourites, Verity Crisp, Yan Yan, and the extremely popular Millicent Sage.
Correcto diddly-o. Unchecked kindness to all, completely out of character. And, might I add, as unsettling as those black and yellow daisy pants she's taken to wearing.
Alarming, I say.
Now, add this to your secret spy notes, Tan Callahan. Just now, after school, I saw Miss Dragone down the street, and guess what shop she was coming out of?
I have to think hard. What kind of shop would a grade 4 teacher come out of? What kind of shop would a grade 4 teacher even need? I have never seen Miss Dragone at the shops, not even the lolly shop. Come to think of it, I didn't think Miss Dragone went to the shops. I take a wild guess.
The shoe shop.
Nope.
The bread shop.
Nope.
The
trophy shop,
I say happily.
That must be it.
Nopety nope,
says Gloria, and I can tell she's enjoying this guessing game.
Tan, she was coming out of the model aeroplane shop. And not only that, she had a model aeroplane under her arm. It was in a box, of course, but it was definitely a model aeroplane. I was close by, hiding behind the big red postbox that is covered in stickers. I got a clear view. Now, what do you think a teacher like Miss Dragone would be doing with a model aeroplane?
Building it?
I say, helpfully.
Piffle! Says Gloria. Miss Dragone has never shown interest in such hobbies.
She brought a kite to school one day, I say, during winter, when it was windy. Remember? It flew onto the roof of the canteen and Mr. Lamble had to climb up and untangle it from the healthy snacks here sign, and everyone thought he was going to slip on the slippery tin and fall and crack his skull open and...
Yes, yes, but really, Tan, a model aeroplane... Miss Dragone doesn't even crochet.
Gloria cannot believe that Miss Dragone doesn't crochet, or knit, or make stylish homemade jewellery and cute little felt mice and colourful patchwork bunting. But I tell Gloria all the time, not everyone is as clever and creative as you, Gloria Pappas. Not even our very own school teacher.
Piffle. This is a new word
from Gloria's dictionary brain and a very new word for me. It means nonsense or rubbish. It is a good word to say and it is fun to practice. Piffle, piffle, piffle. Ted, says my partner, what are you thinking? I'm thinking you're right, Gloria. It is strange. Let's keep Miss Dragone on our watch list a little while longer. Let's make a pact to find out what she's up to once and for all.
Affirmative, says Gloria. Oops, I have to go. Alfie's about to piddle.
Isn't that sweet little dog of yours house trained yet?
Most of the time, says Gloria, with the exception of a few accidents.
Good work, GP, I say.
And Ted, says Gloria.
Yes?
Keep your chin up. Everything will work out fine with the you know what, I'm sure.
I say, over and out, hairy lout. Then we laugh, and I hang up the secret spy phone. I am sick of the you know what problem, and I am sick of the magic eight ball and its tricksy ways. But I am intrigued by Miss Dragone's antics. I truly am. They are unusual, uncalled for, and unteacherly. Miss Dragone is definitely one to watch. In sync. Say in sync. If you are in sync with someone, you are working well together. If you are out of sync with someone, you are not working well together. Sometimes I am out of sync with Miss Dragone, but this is to be expected. She is a very bossy teacher. Antics. Say antics. Miss Dragone often says to me, enough of your silly antics, Tan Callahan. Sit down at once. An antic is an action. It is an action that can be seen as silly or odd or attention-seeking. Nothing I do is ever silly or odd or attention-seeking, unless I mean it to be. My frenemy and classmate, Ted Murphy, on the other hand, wins the golden trophy for silly antics. Trust me when I say that. Two. Talking to my partner, Gloria, about Miss Dragone and her weird behaviour has put me out of my floppish mood and into a secret spy mood. My family do not know this, but sometimes I practice my secret spy skills on them. It is important to practice your skills. Spying is like playing the violin. You have to practice. Except there are no scales involved in spying, and no pesky wonky bow, and mostly there are no screechy noises involved in spying, and these are all added bonuses. Now, I decided a long time ago that if you only have a few goofy sisters and a busy mother to spy on, then that is the luck of the draw. I take up my secret spy binoculars, climb down the ladder, and sneak around the rusty old water tank that is lying on the ground behind HQ, along the side of the hedge and into the far corner of the backyard. First suspect, Emerald Callahan. I twiddle the lens and zoom in on her. Emerald has left Awesome hungry and heartbroken in the kitchen, and now here she is, wearing her mirrored sunglasses, sitting on the love swing, yap, yippity yap, talking into her mobile phone. I cannot hear what is being said, but I know exactly who she is talking to. She is talking to her boyfriend. Yes?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.